Jesus. Praise Master Jesus. You know, children are the gift of the Lord. They are the gift from God, and they are everything. I'm not going to be preaching, I'm just going to be teaching. I'm going to be teaching today, no preaching, so I want you to pay attention. We are talking of the gift from God. These gifts are from God. They are not yours. So it's your responsibility to train them up in the way of the Lord. So that when they are old, they will not depart from it. When you do your part, there are times good children, when they go to school, they start misbehaving. But you will be at peace with yourself. You will never regret that, I did not train him well. You will be proud to say, yes, God, I know I have done my part. But take charge over them. That is, when it's growing older, that thing you planted in that child will grow up. It will have it turn around like the prodigal son. I will say, I can no longer live this kind of life. It will have a rethink. It will have a sober reflection and turn back to where it belongs. Praise Master Jesus. Because the seed in him is growing. Praise Master Jesus. The seed we sow in our children is what Philippians call ulelefe. I don't know the meaning in English language. There is this ulelefe, it's a plant that grows. Even an elephant will mash it. But the plant is still spring up. That is the seed of the word of God in our children. The plant we sow in them, no matter the elephant of the world that will mash it, it will never die, it will spring up because you have given a good foundation. Praise Master Jesus. Teaching our children is our duty and responsibility. The Amplified Version says, train up a child in the way he should go, teaching him to seek God's wisdom and build for his abilities and talents. Even when he is old, he will not depart from it. Teaching them to discover God's ability, God's purposes and will concerning them. And as you are teaching them the things of God, you see them discovering their talents. You see God demonstrating the things of God in them. You see them singing and dancing when you are teaching them the way of the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. Isaiah chapter 54 verse 13. Shall we all read? Let's open our Bibles to the book of Isaiah, chapter 54, verse 13. Are we not there? I want to just briefly say it. The Bible says, all our children shall be taught by the Lord, and great shall be the peace of our children. When you teach them the way of the Lord, by the help of the Holy Spirit cannot come down by himself to teach them. He uses you, most especially the mother, to teach them the way of the Lord. And they will be at peace. You will not see hear any evil news concerning them. You will not see that they will be fighting here and there. No. You will not hear that they have insulted their senior. No. You will not hear that they will misbehave in school. No. They will be at peace. The peace of God that passes all understanding will be with them. So the duty of the parents is to get their children to know their heavenly Father by teaching them the way of the Lord. That is our duty as parents. And this area we are talking about is where the mother is needed most. Mother. You may say the man is the head of the house. He is the priest of the home. Yes. But let me tell you, in child upbringing, 80% is for the woman. While 20 is just for the man. I'm just saying it on my own. I'm just dividing on my own. Major part of training up your child is from the woman. Praise Master Jesus. The Bible says a woman builds her home. Did it say a man builds her home? The woman builds her home. Why the foolish one plucks it down with his own hands? 80% of we the women is our responsibility to bring up our children the way they should go so that they will live as God's heritage here on earth to fulfill his destiny. In the training field of children, the cultivate. You need to brush, you need to cultivate, you need to burn the bush. Those that have worked in farm. Me, I was once a farmer, I'm a good farmer, and there's nothing I don't do. The only thing I've not done as a farm work is to when you have trees, you follow your grandfather to be cutting all the trees. You uproot the trees from the ground. That is the only one I've not done. But when we go to first firewood, we used to cut those small, small tiny ones. There's no farm work I don't do. I am a hard-working woman. I was once a farmer. I know what is called farm work. You need to cut the bush. And the other support, you will receive quite from the other watching. Is there anyone that can tell me with this? You will receive our love from the other. That is the devil. When you are cultivating, trying to bring up your children, you need to receive our love from the other. They will wipe you, but you need to press forward to make sure that the other one, they are met. You brush it and set them on fire. Those things that you don't need. The same way we do in the life of our children. It's the father that will come and water. How do they water it? When the children are going, they want to leave, you have to give them fatherly advice. Praise Master Jesus. It is we, the mothers, that is responsible for the life of our children. It is we, God, we hold responsible, not the man. The father is just to love, but the women are to bring up their children. You are the one that will teach your child. Learn how to greet people when you go outside. When you see auntie, learn how to say good morning. Learn how to say good afternoon. This is, you teach your children. You are the one that will teach your children how to respect their father. So mothers have brought down their children. Brought down their father in the presence of their children. Their children no longer have respect for their father. Praise the Lord.
Jesus.
The word of correction is what the shepherds use those days, all those meru, those sheep is about to go to the side that they don't want to go, they will hit him with the rod. And the sheep will go back to its position. So the rod of correction is what the shepherd is using to drag the sheep to a place of pasture, to a place where they will have good water. Praise Master Jesus. Proverbs chapter 13, verse 24 says, he that spareth the rod hates the son, but he that loveth him shall chastise him many times. That is many times. We are facing problems today in the society where people, where law is not permitted the parents to talk with their children. But why? How are they living? You will see the difference between them and those that are well disciplined. Praise Master Jesus. We as children of God, as godly parents, we should make sure we apply this biblical formula. It is biblical to smile or to beat a child when necessary. You know our spiritual father, the spiritual father of the church, say he gets to a point that he can no longer accept the behavior of the daughter. He gave her the best discipline that she needed that moment. He gave it to her. Of that child changed. Today, she's a singer and a pastor. Because of that thing, she was the one that was now telling others, hey, be careful, be careful. That is funny. That was a testimony. Had they been missing that time, maybe something else would have happened. Or reverse would be the case. Praise the Lord. It is biblical. Don't withhold the word from a child when he's doing something wrong. If he refuses or she refuses to obey, that is a taking. If they say can, they will maintain. Where is it? There are times you need open rebuke. There are times you need secret love. But make sure you do them at the very right time. Praise the Lord. Children are the heritage of God. The fruit of the reward. The womb is his reward. Don't allow God to ask you or your children to say, why did you bring me up this way? Why did you take care of me? Why did you do this? Why did you do that? We should be ready to receive our children at that very old age and say, ah, mommy, I am proud to have you as a mother. Not because you were giving him too much sweet, because you brought him up in the way he should go. By discipline, by correction, by leading, by teaching, by chastising. And I pray that God Almighty will help us in Jesus' name. And to our children, whenever you are corrected by your parents, don't be angry. Don't say they don't love you. No. The Bible says, whom the Lord loveth, he chastises. You are God's heritage. You are the heritage of God. Let God's will be done in your life through your parents. When they are teaching you the right thing, accept it with all your heart. Children, are you hearing me? Obey your parents. Don't disobey them. Don't hide anything from your parents. The best friend you will have in life is your parents. Your friends will lead you to problems. Your friends will forsake you. Your friends will abandon you, but your parents can never abandon you. That's why they are paying your school fees. That's why they are giving you food. That's why they are buying things for you. So you are God's heritage. Make sure you humbly accept correction from your parents. Don't talk back at your parents. Praise the Lord. Don't talk back at them. Make sure you obey. Make sure you learn how to do domestic things at home. Make sure you support them. Praise the Lord. Children, are you hearing me? Clap for our Lord Jesus. Praise Master Jesus. Not only your parents you have to obey. Obey your teachers. Your auntie. Obey when she's correcting you. Don't go and tell your mommy he did it. No. Learn to obey and respond to every given question. If you don't know it, say I don't know it. Don't be angry when you are being chastised. It's for your own good. Respect others. Respect your senior. Don't be rude. Don't be disrespectful. It is not the will of God concerning you as a child. In the presence of your children, you are letting your wife down in their presence. Let them shiver. Let them be afraid when they hear that I again because you have taught them the right way. And I know God Almighty will bless you as you do in Jesus' name. Shall we close our eyes for prayer?